After an accidental fall into a swimming pool, Natalie Newton, a 2-year-old girl from Texas, was rushed to the hospital in an effort to save her life. Attempts to save the young girl's life were incompetent, however, and the young girl was left clinging for life. She was left without oxygen in too long. She became deaf and blind, and her organs were shutting down. Her family appealed to the Hospital Ethics Committee to allow for the young girl to pass away quickly and peacefully with active euthanasia. However, according to Texas law, the only euthanasia allowed is passive euthanasia, which is removing life support. The family, seeing the young girl suffering, decided to take her home to begin the process of passive euthanasia. According to the Natty Foundation, it took 9 long days of pain and hardship for the young girls to pass away. 9 torturous days passed from the moment we removed her feeding tube until our sweet pea took her last breath in her young mother's arms. For 9 days, we had to watch helplessly as she became increasingly confused and delirious. In the final moments, Natalie withered away, losing half of her body weight and becoming nothing more but a shell of the little girl that a few short months ago filled our lives with laughter and happiness. Humane, they say. They obviously have never starved their baby to death. Euthanasia, also known as assisted death or physician-assisted suicide, is intentionally, knowingly, and directly causing the death of another person. My great-aunt Delia was diagnosed with Lou Gehrig's disease when she was 60 years old. She had her own fight for euthanasia because she wanted to be able to die peacefully. Unfortunately, she was refused, and she died at the age of 65. A patient faced with a terminal illness that riddles the victim's bodies should be able to die with dignity and in peace. However, if this person is not able to make a decision because of their illness, the family members should have the right to end their suffering for them. Finally, people need to understand that their view on euthanasia may be warped. Euthanasia needs to be a basic right to the people who wish to end their life with nobility. Death should be a right in today's society. When someone wants to die, they have their own right to end their life by suicide. Although, say someone is suffering and is not physically able to end their life, one needs a basic right to be able to pass away with the assistance of another, such as a doctor. For example, according to a conceptual and moral analysis of suffering, the elimination of suffering should be a priority to the health professions, even more important than preserving life. When death is inevitable, a patient is in a great deal of pain, and there is nothing a doctor can do to cure this person. Physician-assisted suicide may be the best choice for both the doctor and the patient. In fact, according to Ellen Verbeckel and Eva Jaspers in their article, A Comparative Study on Permissiveness Toward Euthanasia, someone who has been in a great deal of suffering or close to death, she was in favor of euthanasia. Therefore, the majority of people who are against euthanasia are those who have never experienced a great deal of pain or suffering. Many people have stories who speak of this pain. Tony Nicholson's story is one of euthanasia. The 58-year-old man had suffered a massive stroke in Athens, Greece in 2005, which resulted in locked-in syndrome. Locked-in syndrome is a condition in which is often described as being buried alive. He was aware of his surroundings, but was paralyzed from the neck down and unable to speak. The only way for him to communicate was through a system on a computer screen that wrote letters when he blinked a certain way. "My life is miserable, demeaning, and undignified," Tony Nicholson tells New York Times. "It's astonishing that in 1969 we can put a man on the moon, yet in 2012 we cannot devise adequate rules for government-assisted dying." Some may argue that euthanasia may become a cost-effective way to treat the ill to get rid of the ill instead of actually treating them. But sometimes someone is too ill to make their own decisions. When a patient is not physically able to make their own decision of life or death, the patient's fate should be put into the hands of the family members involved. An example of this is the Terri Schiavo case. The tug of war of the life or death of Terri Schiavo is quite possibly the most debated story of euthanasia in the history of the United States. On February 1990, 26-year-old Terry Schiavo collapsed in her home from an imbalance of potassium due to an eating disorder. Her body crashed, and her brain was deprived of oxygen for 10 fatal minutes, leaving her in a vegetative state for nearly 15 years. Terry Schiavo's husband, Michael Schiavo, pushed for her right to die case. After 8 years of her being in a vegetative state, he accepted the fact that she wasn't coming back, and he wanted her to die in peace. My aim is to carry out Terry's wishes, Michael Schiavo told WND after court proceedings in 2002. If Terry would know that I had someone taking care of her bodily functions, she would kill us all in a heartbeat. She'd be so angry. Protesters for and against the euthanasia of Terry Schiavo stormed the court, and the story made headlines across the nation. The case was the most controversial case of euthanasia in history. Mark Gelman was a writer for Newsweek and wrote about the Terry Schiavo case. He once stated, "The only three facts all parties to the Schiavo case agree are true are that she's alive, she's innocent, and she is mute. Everything else is in dispute." Protests were in the thousands. Michael Schiavo finally won his case on March 18, 2005. The feeding tube was removed, and Terry Schiavo died 14 days later due to severe dehydration. If the court had granted Michael Schiavo's wishes sooner, Terry Schiavo would have died in peace and harmony. People have many different views of euthanasia today. Most religious groups disapprove of euthanasia, and some religious groups forbid it altogether. Religions disapprove for a number of reasons. God has forbidden it, human life is sacred, and humans have a special value and dignity that others do not possess. While human life is indeed sacred, there is a line between life and death, and an essentially brain-dead person hangs in the balance of that line. Euthanasia can be somewhat of a blessing to those who wish to end their life with dignity. While religious people are main groups who disapprove of euthanasia, others find it wrong as well. The Hippocratic Oath is an oath that has been kept sacred by doctors around the world for centuries. It is the oldest binding document in history. It states that doctors will treat the sick to the best of their ability. With euthanasia, however, some believe that doctors go against their oath by letting a person die. However, it can be argued that the oath is far outdated. It has already been changed multiple times in history, for example, letting women study medicine. The oath can be changed again to allow euthanasia if the person wishes to die. Euthanasia needs to be a basic right for people who wish to end their lives with dignity and respect, and for the families of a sick loved one. Euthanasia is a widely controversial topic in today's society and has been making a mark, especially in the United States. It is clear that euthanasia will remain an issue to the American people for many years and many years to come because of the religious, moral, ethical, and practical reasons of the right to die versus the right to live. Today, we have covered why euthanasia should be allowed for people who wish to die and also be an option for family members to let go of a terminally ill loved one. Also, we have covered the main reasons why euthanasia is illegal and why it should be changed. While almost every major religious group denies euthanasia as a practice, many people in the world fight for the right to die. We must accept that this is a new day and age, and people should be given every right they deserve, even the right to die. Since people push for right to live all over the world, the right to die is also important in people's basic freedoms in America. Assisted death needs to be a basic right to the people in today's society. Thank you.